Alright, so welcome to this video guys. In this video, we're going to create our sitemap, but before that, just make sure you have verified your website in Google Webmaster Tools. And if you have not, then you will find somewhere in this video, you will find a link wherein you can just click on that link and it will have the video where you're going to verify your website inside Google Webmaster Tool. So assuming you have already done that, let's move ahead with creating our sitemap for the website. So basically, what sitemap is? Sitemap is a way for website owners to tell search engines about all the pages that exist on their website. So it helps in better crawling. Alright, so why do you need sitemap? Sitemap is very important when we are dealing with SEO, which is search engine optimization. But adding a sitemap doesn't affect your rankings. Alright, sitemaps are just very useful for new websites and blogs, as most of the new blogs usually don't get many backlinks to their individual posts. So it becomes harder for search engines to discover all of their posts and pages. So sitemaps allow those websites to help search engines crawl their sites more efficiently. But now, if it is a popular website already, then sitemaps allow your website to interact with search engines more effectively, and search engines can guess how often your site is updated, which parts of your website are more frequently updated than others. So it sets the crawl rate for your site. Alright, and this improves the overall visibility of your site to the search engines. So this is basically the fundamentals of what is a sitemap and why do you need a sitemap. So now let's move ahead and create sitemap for your website. So the first and the foremost thing which you need to do is visit this website. So now we'll go to this website. I have already opened this website. So that is www.xml-sitemaps.com. So over here, you can create the sitemap for your website absolutely for free. So what we need to do is just scroll down a little bit, grab the URL of your website and copy and paste it over here. Then second thing which you need to change is the frequency. Make sure, I mean, this frequency is all about how often are you updating your website. So let's suppose if it's a blogging website, then how often you are updating blog posts. Would it be daily basis? Would it be weekly basis? So it's totally up to you. How often are you updating your website? So let's say in my case, it's always or maybe daily basis. All right, I'll say daily basis. Then I'll once again scroll down. You don't have to do anything with this latest modification or last modification. Just set the priority as automatically calculated priority and then hit start. All right. So as soon as you hit start, now the sitemap generation is under process, but it says that there was an error while accessing the URL specified. All right. So now this is a good sign that it has gone via an error. So I can just mention and highlight one very important point in front of you. All right. So now just because it's a WordPress website, if we go inside the settings part, all right, let's go to settings and general. Then there would be two WordPress URLs. Here there are. So WordPress address URL and site address URL. So for me, the login address. For me, the login address or the way which I the URL which I used for logging in inside my WordPress panel is this one. However, my actual website URL is with a www. So I'll have to copy this link and now I'll once again go to this and I will enter the entire website. So previously there was no www and now there is www as well. So now let's try once again doing the same thing. So frequency is daily and I set the priority as automatically and I hit start. So let's see, the sitemap generation is in progress now and it won't give me any error. All right. So now let's just wait for a while and there you go. Your sitemap is ready. All right. So your sitemap is ready and there are two steps left. So what we need to do is we need to download our sitemap file by clicking over here. So we'll just click over here and we'll download the sitemap file. So our sitemap.xml file would be downloaded. Now what we need to do is we need to go to our HostGator account, the cPanel, the control panel for our not the HostGator. If you are using HostGator, then you will go to the control panel of your hosting account, which is HostGator. If it is GoDaddy, then you will go to GoDaddy hosting account. In my case, I'm using ecowebhosting.co.uk. So right now I'm logged inside the C panel of my hosting account. Then once you are inside your hosting account's C panel, you will click on File Manager. As soon as you click on File Manager, you'll have to go to your root directory, which is public_HTML. And over here, you will click on Upload File. So in my case, I'm not able to see. Yeah, this is my upload option. So I'll click on Upload and I'll choose the file. So I'll go to my download and I'll search for the sitemap which I have just generated, which is this one. And I'll say upload. And now this is done. So I'll close the file and I'll search for the sitemap which is over here. So now this file is uploaded. So now let's go to the second part. Right, so the first part is over. Download the sitemap file here and upload it into the domain root folder of your site. All right, now second step is check that the sitemap is showing for you at this address. So we'll click on this and let's see if the sitemap is showing or not. So there you go. Right now, I'm able to see the sitemap over here. All right, the sitemap is shown over here. So now I will go to the Google Webmaster account, and as soon as we click on that, it will open up our webmaster's homepage. So this is where now we would be uploading our sitemap. So now we have successfully created the sitemap for our website. So the last step which is remaining is uploading our sitemap for our website inside Google Webmaster Tool or Search Console. So we'll check this step in the last video. So see you in the next one, guys, and hit the thumbs up button if you like this video, if you found this video as helpful, and subscribe and to watch the next video, which is the last part, in which we'll upload the sitemap into our Google Webmasters. Cheers. Bye-bye.